Hey, Internet! It's Carfarty back for the grand, true, ultimate finale of my Oracle of Ages and Seasons Cursed Let's Plays. We're taking on Twinrova today. And the bonus dungeon, so let's see, we need to go everywhere where they're not looking, so straight up. And then just straight up again. And straight up again. And now to the right. And to the right again. There we go. It's Zelda, let's save her. Oh, nope, forget that. I like the Game Boy Color visual effects, though. Very nicely done. So, Artie! You finally reached the altar! Bother, we can't have you scampering about up here! So we've dragged you in here. The flames of sorrow, destruction, and despair burn brightly. The return of the evil King Ganon approaches. The holy sacrifice Zelda is all that remains. When we call Ganon's spirit into the vessel, it will be done. You can't stop us. Prepare to meet your doom. Oh boy. This is not good. Alright, so now we fight Twinrova. Basically, they'll shoot spells at us, we need to fire the ice spells back at the fire one, and the fire spells back at the ice one. Safest way to do it? Just hang out in this corner and swing like crazy. They won't actually fly in this corner, and if we swing like this, we'll always be able to reflect their blasts. This makes it extremely difficult to hit them, but safety first, because I want to get through this fight without taking any damage. Aw, that almost hit. I do love the music for this fight, though. There we go. You have to hit them 3 times, I believe. Oh, that was so close. Play ball. Ow. Oh, why couldn't you have flown just a little faster? Yeah, so this is gonna take a while, but like I said, it's the safest way to do it. Oh, I hit him. Alright, cool, first form down. Oh ho ho ho, I did not think you would get so far. But I shall not fall like Nox and Varan. See my true power. We'll sacrifice you so the evil king can return. Alright, time for Twinrova's second form. This one is much more annoying. Much more annoying. Ow. So basically, we gotta go around. Okay, I just used my potion. I don't want that. Yeah, this fight is gonna be very, very hard in a cursed playthrough. Darn it! This is where I wanted the Master Sword. Darn it! Let's try the bomb shoes. Nothing doing. Great. Darn it! Okay. When you stun her like that, you want to shoot her with the seed shooter. That's the only way you can damage her. Perhaps Big Goron Sword would be a better idea. Maybe not. I can't tell if that's incredibly effective or incredibly ineffective. Ow, ow, ow. Ouch. One of the hardest fights in the- actually, this is probably the hardest fight in the game. Okay, Master Sword is more powerful than the Goron Sword. For those of you who are curious, at least if you're doing spin attacks. I really wish I had done this Oracle of Seasons for after Oracle of Ages. If I had done Oracle of Seasons after Oracle of Ages, I would have Rock's Cape in my hands, and that's much better than Rock's Feather. That's bad, that's bad, that's bad, that's bad! Alright. Sword beams work wonders. I hate how you have no momentum on the ice. You stink! Seriously, this fight goes on forever. She's got so much HP. I'm gonna try something. Mirror Shield might be very helpful in this fight. Or it could be almost useless. That's always an option. I also realized I probably should have started this with full HP. I was missing half a heart, and that makes all the difference, because... well, without that half a heart, I can't shoot sword beams from the get-go. Hehe, good, I was afraid that I was gonna miss her. Ow. Charge hits do so much damage. Alright, for real? Are you kidding me? You can't even do a spin attack on her without, like, going in the lava? alright. Can't believe I'm saying this, but ice form might be better than fire form. Because fire form is just like... you always go in the lava. Darn it! Darn it. The ice physics are bad, though. Darn it! I hate lava! Yeah, ice form is much better than fire form, because fire form, you can't spin attacker without going in the lava, pretty much. Even though the controls on the ice physics are, like, unbearable. Ow. Alright. You know, my original goal was to get through this fight without taking damage. Now my goal is to just get through this fight. If you so much as touch even a pixel of the lava, you're going in. I guess that might be an option. Nope, never mind. Whew, that changed at just the right time. This is one of the most stressful fights I've ever done in a, any of my Let's Plays. I haven't been this stressed since Bearstormin'. Oh, come on! If this keeps up, I'm gonna have to use save states in the middle of the battle. And I really don't want to have to do that, because that feels like cheating. Oh, for crying out loud! Man, 4 charge shots is all it takes. Oh, come on! These ice physics are just the worst. I hate the fire form because it's, like, impossible to predict where she's going to go. And if she goes where you are completely screwed, there's nothing you can do about it. But if you don't take a chance, then you'll never damage her. No! I knew this was a mistake. This is the only part of a cursed playthrough I haven't actually done. Like, I've beaten Oracle of Seasons and Ages in a cursed playthrough before actually recording them. I have never actually done this. New idea. I'm going to ignore her fire form and just wait for her to go back to the ice form. Unless she happens to come at the bottom of the level. Oh, for... I did not even touch the lava pool! Thank you. That should not have launched me in the lava. Fight is so annoying. I feel like this is the only way I'm actually going to do it, though. Only way I'm gonna do it is if I ignore her fire form and then just focus on the ice form. As horrible as the controls are, that's the only way I'm gonna be able to do it. The problem is Okay, I've got a new plan. My new plan is I'm going to get her down to almost no HP in the ice form, so then when she turns into the fire form, I can just instantly kill her. The problem is if those ice fiends are just moving in just the wrong way, you can't really dodge them. Literally every single card is stacked against you in this fight. And a curse playthrough anyways. I would give anything to be able to wear the snowshoe ring during this fight. This seems to be working to an extent. I'm taking damage, but I am actually getting through the fight. I just hate these stupid ice fiends that always move around in the circle! Okay, so touching her is a very bad idea, because you lose, like, 2 whole hearts for doing that. This could work. I never thought I'd see the day where Colorful Artie would choose to go to the ice physics area as much as he could. Okay, that is not fair. You should not be allowed to spawn in the lava. That is bad. That's not normal. This also means I think I'm close to the end of the fight, but... ow. Blast! Admittedly, this is all my own fault for doing a cursed playthrough. Maybe this is why nobody on the internet's done one of these before. No, no, no! One screw up, just one screw up, and you have to start everything over. Even if you don't screw up, you still usually have to start over, just because of the ice all the time. Twinrova are not messing around! I hate ice! This fight is completely unfair, you know what? Thank you. My heart is beating so fast right now. Yes! Yes! Oh, Ganon's return was but a step away. Artie, it is not over. Our rites have failed, but by sacrificing this body, Ganon will return! Oh boy. Now we're getting ready for the fight of our lives. I'm scared.
Destroy all, kill all.
Welcome to the true ultimate final boss of the Oracle games, Ganon. And he is nasty. Oh sure, if you're allowing yourself, like, the Red Ring and such, he's not a big deal. But we're cursed, so this is gonna be hard. I do love the music. Can you do that move more? Thank you. Spin attack him. He might be more legitimately hard than Twinrova, but he's probably not as hard as in the long run because he's more fair. I have no idea really what to do about that move. Also, if you don't have the Master Sword, you have to spin attack him if you want to even damage him. Alright, thus far he's not too bad, once you memorize his pattern. Uh-oh. Oh no, no, Link, get up! Wow! I can't really stay mad at Ganon, though, because he's so awesome in this. He attacks with a giant trident, and he's blue, and he's got magic powers, and he's just amazing. And he's got an awesome boss song. And if I can do this, then, like, I'm the king of the Oracle games. Until there's a guy who comes along and manages to do all of this with, without getting any upgrades. Dang Ganon, that is a sweet-looking ball of dark magic. Oh, okay. Oh, this is bad. This is where he reverses your controls. Oh man, this is so epic, though. Darn it! I stepped on his cape! This is the good kind of hard, though, because you can dodge all his attacks fairly easily, as long as you're fast enough. Unlike Twinrova's, where you're dealing with, like, ice physics and a bunch of other completely unfair things. Like, that move is very intimidating, but you can dodge it pretty consistently once you get the timing down. Link, you're doing amazing. But I'm like, I am thoroughly enjoying this fight right now. Because this feels like a really good final fight, just the fight between good and evil. Darn it. It's hard to tell where the walls are. The funny thing is, if you're playing this with the Master Sword and the Red Rain, you can literally spin attack him to death, I think, in 3 hits. Ow. I think this is one of the best fights against Ganon in the franchise. Ow! I'm so glad I didn't try to do a perfect run on a Twinrova, because Ganon's not nearly as hard as Twinrova is. This is a seriously amazing fight. Just don't let him warp on top of you. Ah, this again?
I am the evil king, Ganon.
Yes! Yes! Oh my gosh. That sequence of fights was one of the hardest video game challenges I've ever done. And man, do I feel good having completed it. Artie! It's ended. Thank you, Artie. You halted the completion of the rites that would have revived Ganon. Since they could not sacrifice me in their final rite, the powers of darkness could revive only a mindless, raging Ganon. Your power, wisdom, and courage were able to prevent Twinrova's planned resurrection of Ganon. Now hope and peace can return to the hearts of the people. Thank you! You are a true hero. Let us return to the others. Oh no! The castle is crumbling now that the powers of Shadow wane. We must get out of here! What do we do? Never fear, the female maple tree will save us, magically, with her leaves, somehow. Artie, you did it! I knew you could! Leave this to me! Oh, that fight against Ganon was one of the most fun I've had doing a boss fight ever. Welcome back, Artie! Now the world is at peace. I knew you could do it, Artie. And I knew you'd come back. Welcome back, Zelda. And you too, Artie. It's all over, isn't it? I knew you would find a way, Artie. Let us dance together again. Zelda, I'm glad to see you return safely, Artie. You are all I expected. I always believed in you. Artie, the free triangle on your left hand symbolize power, wisdom, and courage. These are the mark of the hero who is fated to appear when peace crumbles in Hyrule. With the essences of nature and time and the courage you possess, you have fought back the powers of evil. The guidance of the Triforce has made you into this legendary hero. Thank you, Artie. Ooh. Megatree's not happy about that, but Link definitely is. Oh, dang, he's got his arm around her, is what it looks like. That's awesome. Legend of Zelda, Oracle of Ages. And that's the Link playthrough. And that is the end of over a year of Let's Playing. Where the heck is this? I haven't seen this before. What town is this? Why is Nehru carrying some bread in a paper bag? I guess she just went shopping. Oh yeah. Yeah, I don't recognize any of these places. There's Din dancing. She was the main damsel in distress from Oracle of Seasons, for those of you who didn't know. It's Moosh! You remember, we used him for like 2 seconds in both games. And Dimitri, we also used him for like 2 seconds in both games. Hey, Ricky, buddy, you are my best pal. I hope you reappear in a future game, in a 2D game, 'cause 3D game, Ricky would be a little weird. Look at that, Link's taking lessons in boxing. And what is this right now? Zelda's looking at the moon on a starry night, and she saw a shooting star, and it looks like Pinocchio's background from the movie. And look at that, the music was by those people, and thank you oh so much, because the music in the Oracle games is underrated. Oh yes, indeed. Thank you guys so much for watching this series. This ended up being longer than Oracle of Seasons, which I kind of figured. Hey, Yamada. Nice. Now that I'm done with Oracle of Ages and Diddy Kong Racing, I do believe I'll start another game. I already know which one it's gonna be. It's more like the one after the really short one that I'm planning. I'm wondering what that'll be. That didn't make sense. Basically, I know the next Let's Play I'm gonna do, and it's gonna be a very short Let's Play, so I need to have another Let's Play already planned in advance for when that one's over, and I'm not sure about what that one's going to be. I've narrowed it down to a couple things. If you have never played the Oracle games, I strongly recommend it. Both of them. I personally like Seasons a little more. Ages is good too, though. Link's Awakening's also fun, not quite as good as them, though. And I will be doing more Zelda Let's Plays in the future. Next one I do will probably be the original, which I have only beaten once, so I am going to die a lot in that. And I won't be doing any special playthrough of it, because it's hard enough as is. And check it out! It's the Triforce! And it turned into free birds. That's new. Oh, that's right! This leads directly into Link's Awakening, where he sails off on the boat. The end. We will continue Link's Awakening. Eventually, I have no idea when. Probably not even this year. But anyways, thank you all so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, please leave a like and subscribe. It will be great, and it'll let you know when I put out new videos, which is usually daily, so it's always nice to get alerted of that. Anyways, thanks again from the bottom of my heart. Sorry if I was bad-tempered during the Twinrova fight, but the Ganon fight more than made up for it. Anyways, I hope to see you guys for my next Let's Play. Have a great day, and God bless you wherever you are.